Teaching Tilt Brush. And this episode of Tilt Brush, we are specifically looking at valve index and how it works with Tilt Brush. Now, this is not a review of the device. This is not a review of valve index. This is merely to show the differences that a valve index user will have when they're using Tilt Brush in the environment. The controllers were originally designed using the HTC Vive wands, which is why they look similar. You can see, since my calibration is a little off, you can actually see the difference in the way the controllers look. Now, with the index, we've got A, B buttons instead of what we had on the Vive wands. We also have an up and down thumb pad that actually does have pretty good left and right reading as well. We also have the little thumb joysticks, which do have a click. These types of things are what we're getting into with a valve index, as opposed to using it with one of the other devices. Now, the thumb pad is probably the biggest difference. On a Vive, you have a large round thumb pad like that. The little strip does have left and right sensitivity, but you may have to do more than one swipe to get the full size range. You can also use the thumb wheel, the joystick. A single left and right will step you little bits bigger and smaller, but you can also roll the joystick. So starting it all the way right and rolling it across the top to the left is another way for it to incrementally slide, whether you're doing it to change the size of your brush or you're doing it to do, for example, undo and redo on the other hand, or using it to try to turn the menu on that side. You can either use the thumb joystick or the thumb pad. Now, with both of these as well, sliding it up and down will often read as sliding it left and right, depending on what menu you're looking at. But I find the sliding left and right works fairly reliably, and the rolling left and right works fairly reliably as well. Now, be careful. If you roll too far, you start rolling back the other way, and as you can see, it pivots your control that direction as well. Now, the headset itself, your visual clarity, the definition, the resolution is higher on the Vive. So your curves and lines look sharper and clearer. They aren't actually any different. The math is the same. So this sketch looked at on a Quest, looked at on a Vive, looked at on the index is going to be the sharpest and clearest. The Quest is going to have the most trouble at a larger polygon count. But for the most part, the index is going to give you the same visual, but just at a sharper, clearer definition, higher resolution. That's not something we can really show on the screen here without doing screenshots, and we might do that in a later video, a comparison video. But for now, it's just going to give the artist a little more natural view, a little more freedom in the artwork itself. So we've got the thumb pads, we've got the thumb joysticks. Now we've also got on these index controllers, A and B buttons. The A button is our quick tools menu. So I can use the A button to quickly switch to an eyedropper, or I could use it to quickly switch to an eraser, So the A button acts as your quick tools menu, the A button. The B button actually acts the same as a grip. Now with a wand, on a Vive, you're actually holding on to them. So the grip is an intentional squeeze. With an index controller, they're much more sensitive. So it's possible to be squeezing without intending to. So as long as you keep your fingers relaxed, you can use that B trigger to grab as well. So if I've got something painted and I use the selection tool to select it, I can use the B button to grab it and move it around. So I'm not gripping, I'm actually using the B button as the grip. Or I could use two B buttons to change the size, that type of thing. So instead of a grip, I can use a B. The only time that won't help is if I want to reset. So if I've been moving around and changing the universe, we've seen how a grip thumb will put you back to the beginning. Well, if I'm using my thumb for the grip, that ain't gonna work. So I do need to grip thumb trigger takes me back to the reset, back to the beginning. But thumb B button can be used as a grip as well. So I could grab and toss. There we go, to make it go away. So that's some of the differences a valve index user is going to have when using Tilt Brush. Mostly it's how your thumb controls are going to work. Grip and trigger are still pretty much the same. The index, even though we have finger sensitivity in the controllers, Tilt Brush does not at this point make use of them. It is now currently August 2019, so we're hoping in future updates they may give us other features with our fingers. But for now, index users, you've got a higher resolution viewpoint, you've got different thumb controls, so you'll need to practice. Especially those of you moving from Vive to Index, the difference in controllers will take a little bit of getting used to. But it's a great headset and a great program, so hopefully you guys will get some good use out of this so that you can try doing things on your own. Is that even visible? That's not even, that's barely visible. Let's see the right thing. There we go. So we've enjoyed bringing these different headsets. We've got a Oculus Quest version. We have our HTC Vive as the standard version. We now have the Valve Index version. We're hopefully going to be bringing you an Oculus Rift version as well, so you can really see what all the different headsets do using this Tilt Brush program. Thanks for joining us, and have fun Tilt Brushing!
Good, we have sold separately.